What's going on, everybody?
Hey, you guys.
Welcome back to East Africa with Willie and Rachel. We are super excited to be sitting with you again.
Praise Amen. God.
So, today we are continuing to talk about mm-hmm. breaking free from sin. And I want to reiterate, the first five teachings of this series
yes.
was about who we are in Christ, mm-hmm. the forgiveness we have in Christ,
yeah.
the righteousness we have in Christ, and our relationship
yes.
with God. Mm-hmm. And that is the foundation of this teaching.
Absolutely.
Here's the thing, though. There are other principles mm-hmm. to begin to take advantage of that the Word reveals to us. However, if you're not walking in those, then the other ones come off. They're just self-help.
Right.
And they'll help a little bit, but you won't really break free from sin. Mm-hmm. If you're going to demolish sin in your life and break free from
yeah,
sin
amen.
And run the path that God has for your life, a consistency with a buoyancy and a power, then it's going to come through implementing those first mm-hmm. five teachings, and then you build off of that, praise
Absolutely.
God. So if you haven't listened to those teachings, you can go to our YouTube channel and catch up on those, praise God.
Amen.
Today we're going to talk about love.
Mm-hmm.
And not just God's love to us, not just our love to God, but the culmination of understanding even what love is. For instance, God so loved the world that he gave his
Amen.
Only begotten son. To realize, 1 John chapter 4 says that God is love. And we see that John 3:16 says that God so loved the world that he
yeah.
gave. And so if love is giving and God is love,
yeah.
then actually understanding even the definition of love begins to give you power over your own mind, your soul, understanding who God is, to understand that he's a giver and he
yeah.
loves you. And it shores up so many things.
Mm-hmm.
Let's just pretend like me, if Rachel and I were not married, but we were dating, if I'm trying to have sex with her, she could be able to see, wait a second, mm-hmm. this guy doesn't love me, or at least doesn't understand true love, because love doesn't take. Love gives, and if he loved me, he would wait for me till we were married, and then, you know, all that is awesome, but after the marriage, praise God. And so, you can understand even a lot of what sin is, and through love. And like we talked about having good friends, Rachel,
yep.
about how
Amen.
Important that is, about evil communication corrupts good habits.
Mm-hmm.
And again, that how do you understand what good communication is or good friendships are? Is someone loving you? Are they honoring you? Are they adding value to your life?
Mm-hmm.
And understanding love mm-hmm. produces so much fruit mm-hmm. when it in regards to sin, because it gives a path for everything we've talked about to run off of.
Yeah. Absolutely.
I mean, if you're trying to discern a good friend and you don't understand what love even is, it's very hard.
Yeah.
Because you might be hanging out with people who are tearing you down personally, speaking down to you
yeah.
all the time. And then, you know, it's really hard to walk free from sin, Rachel,
right.
when you are consistently seeing yourself at a lowly state.
Yep.
And you're just not very good and you
yeah.
wish you could measure up. You want people to bring you up and to lift you up. And when I understood God's love to me, it was supernatural power. I don't think I immediately said, oh, this is giving me power over sin, or this is giving me power to love my wife
mm-hmm.
and to not be in strife.
Mm-hmm.
But it just naturally rebounded. And the more I understood what love was, the more I understood, oh, and this
yeah.
is who God is.
Right.
And this is how, like, I want to treat other people.
Yeah.
And it creates a standard, a healthy standard of how I want to act. And it creates a healthy standard of, I know this is the character of my God too.
Absolutely, mm-hmm. yeah. In 1 John 3:13, it says, by this we know love, because he laid down his life for us.
Mm-hmm.
And we also ought to lay down our lives for the brethren.
Mm-hmm.
You know, when we have the image of the fact that we know love
mm-hmm.
by the fact that Jesus laid down his life
yeah.
for us. See, I love the scripture because first we are receiving something.
Yeah.
First we are receiving that love.
Mm-hmm.
Now we give that love.
Amen.
And the truth is that sin, why it is so damaging in our lives, is because it doesn't just hurt us.
Mm.
Most of the time it's not just hurting us.
Mm-hmm.
It's hurting people around us.
Yes.
It damages the environment that we live in.
Yeah.
It's not laying down our lives
Mm-mm.
for the brethren.
That's so good, yeah.
It's selfish. Yeah. It's self-seeking. Mm-hmm. It's consuming.
Yeah, sin is in itself just
selfish. It's
selfish.
Because you know what? Even if you're saying, well, I'm just watching pornography on my screen, I'm not hurting anybody. Mm-hmm. Yes, you are. Mm-hmm. That woman,
yeah,
you are exploiting her.
Mm-hmm.
You are a part of a lot of times sex trafficking or her in prostitution,
yep,
or her being used and abused because the pornography industry is a nasty,
yep,
and mean industry, treating women like objects.
Even the movie industry, every time you,
yeah,
purchase or go to see a movie that has just nasty stuff in it, you've put money towards
promoting that.
That promotion.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And that's harmful to people.
Mm-hmm.
It's not just harmful to you.
Thank you for saying that. So good.
Yeah.
And if you viewed love like, Lord, I can't, not only do I not want to do this just because it's wrong,
yeah,
I see this standard, mm-hmm, of love that I have put in my heart because,
yeah,
I've viewed how you treat me.
Yeah.
And I don't want to step over that line. It becomes a battle cry. You know what I mean?
It does.
It becomes a battle cry in our life,
yeah,
to where I'm not going to act like, it's so easy to go act like the world. Just,
yeah,
go walk according to the,
yeah,
flesh. But this is something pure and wonderful,
yeah,
that I get to be a part of.
Right.
To understand love.
Absolutely.
And to treat people with honor,
yeah,
and respect. It's,
see,
magnificent.
That's why it's so important to focus on the fact that what Jesus did for you was,
mm-hmm,
the real example of love. Like you said, it was giving. It was selfless. And so now when you receive that love, you're not empty. You have power. You have a deposit. You have something that is filling,
amen,
your heart. And it can overflow. Like, you know, if you're struggling with something and it's affecting your family, it's,
mm-hmm,
affecting your children.
Yeah.
It's affecting your wife. You can stop and say, wait a minute. This is how I know love, that Jesus laid,
yeah,
down his life for me.
Mm.
That's what I'm going to fill myself upon. I'm going to love my family in that same way.
Amen.
So I'm going to say no to these things because I see that it's,
mm-hmm,
not love. It's,
mm-hmm,
not loving them.
Yeah.
Or it's not loving whoever is around me.
Yeah.
And you know what? God loved me. God loved me enough to die for me. He also loved them.
Yep. Amen.
The people that are being hurt, he loved them. And if you'll look at them also in the fact that he loved them and he died for them, everything kind of starts to change.
Yeah. Amen.
In that sphere, in that shape, in that place of,
yeah,
love.
And it takes the pressure off you. Like I see, even in ministry, a lot of ministers, they feel such a pressure to succeed oftentimes that they'll say things that they ought not say.
Yeah.
They'll take advantage of church members, et cetera, et cetera. Just trying to make it even in ministry.
Right.
But where you have love as the standard, it just,
yeah,
it makes things easy because success isn't worth it if you,
yeah,
have to go get it through a means that is not loving,
yeah,
people. As soon as you get off that track,
mm-hmm,
it's a steep, steep thing to fall,
yeah,
off of. You want to remain on that spot to where you're walking in love towards other people, loving others as God is loving,
yeah,
you. And it's a place of peace.
Yeah, it is.
It's a place of where you're not putting your heart in a compromising,
mm-hmm,
situation all the time.
Mm-hmm.
And you're consistently filling yourself up on the love of God so that you can even see what love is.
That's it. I was going to go right here for you.
Go ahead.
No.
I wouldn't even... we love him because he first loved us. 1 John 4:19.
Yeah.
I wouldn't even know how to treat other people. I mean, I could stay away from stealing from them, I guess,
mm-hmm,
because the word says that. But as far as explicitly being able to show a kindness to people,
mm-hmm,
and stuff, that really comes from,
mm-hmm,
God acting that way towards me.
Mm-hmm.
And me just gleaming,
mm-hmm,
my Father. Like literally imitating him as Paul told us to do. Paul said, imitate me just as I also imitate God,
yeah,
the Father. And so that's that. It makes things a lot simpler when we break it down and see,
yeah,
that, wow, I can gleam off of what Jesus,
yeah,
did. I can see how he treats me and I can go treat other people that way.
And you're filled up with that love.
And when you're filled up with that love and it really starts to see, it makes sin look as icky as it is.
It is icky.
It makes it not as
drawing.
It
is. But
amen?
You guys are the righteousness of God in,
yes,
Christ Jesus. This
praise
love
God
is freely flowing to,
mm,
you. And you know love by what Jesus did for you.
Amen.
So receive that by faith, you guys. We've been so blessed to be with you on this series. Like I said, or we said, please go check out the first 1 through 5,
yeah,
on our YouTube channel. Don't miss those because they are really going to bless you and be the,
amen,
foundation of this teaching for breaking free from sin,
amen,
you guys. All right, we love you and we will see you next time.